Om Shanti. We welcome Brother Bridge Mohan Baiji with us on this first online Santawasi retreat in Malaysia. And for information, let me just give a brief introduction of Brother Bridge Mohan Baiji. He is the additional Secretary General of Brahma Kumaris. He's a spokesman for the Brahma Kumaris, and he's also heading the accounts for Brahma Kumaris. And also, he is also the director of, I'm just hearing for the first time, Jollywood Studio in Gurgaon. Yeah. And also, he is also the director of Delhi. And Bridge Mohan Baiji, you know, is responsible for many of Baba's VIP service in Delhi and in India, because Delhi is going to be the Faristan of the new world. And today, this morning, he's going to speak to us about the relearning the lessons of the beginning for the final times. And before we call upon him to speak, let me ask Parubhai to welcome him with a bouquet of flowers.
Bridge Mohan Bhai, welcome to this part of the world. Your audience are actually Baba's right hands from Malaysia, so I know how to position your lecture to address our people here. And at the same time, nice to welcome you as a Pandav. No? So a Pandav is welcoming another Pandav. A bouquet of flower for you, Brother Bridge Mohan Bhai.
Thank you. Thank you. Om Shanti. Baba's sweet children, my dear sisters and brothers, I am very happy to be with you through this online technology. When we think of confluence age, our birth as Brahmins, and then slowly and slowly confluence age coming to a close, we look back to the grand plan of Shiv Baba of transforming this world from hell of suffering and sorrow to paradise of joy and happiness. The planner is God Almighty, so therefore the plan is perfect. The executors are Baba's children who have to become most perfect from most imperfect. So here lies the story of ourselves individually, the Brahman family collectively, and the souls of the whole world. So, since Bab Dada is Trikaldarshi and also made us Master Trikaldarshi, that is the greatest power we get right in the beginning. Because they say, forewarned is forearmed. When you know of something in advance, you can prepare for it. Just imagine that no one in the whole world, not a single soul, excepting the Brahmins, are aware that the present drama is coming to end and the new drama is also in formation, preparation for beginning. No one in the world knows. So how empowered we are to be able to set our plans of our lives according to this foreknowledge which Baba has given. So therefore, when we took birth as Baba's Brahmin children, we got this power and totally our attitude changed to life, to happiness, to everything. Because till then, we were thinking we are human beings, knowing nothing about the soul or what is happening around, just pushed into the crowd and then playing our role, whatever came in before us. But when Baba told us our entity of soul, our immortality, our cyclic rebirths in the world drama, how the cycle, old one is coming to close and the new one is going to begin, and how to be fortunate souls to be able to go into the new world, and the effort required for that, and Baba's help for that effort, everything. So he trained our life, and we now knew that whatever we do in consciousness of the body will be mortal, perishable, and also short-lived. So that was one big thing which changed our whole thinking. And whatever we do as a soul will be immortal, will be forever, for long period of time in the drama. And therefore, we instantly decided that we have not to go for short-lived things. Additionally, Baba told us that because you are yourself becoming entitled to the new world, and in the process also helping Baba in transforming the world, although Baba is doing getting everything done, but still Baba requires some messengers in the physical body, because Baba is not in the physical body and the message has to be given to the souls in the physical bodies. So in return for that, Baba said that not only you will get imperishable, eternal blessings and bliss, additionally, you will also get all the comforts of present life, that is to say the physical things, life which will come to you like a shadow. Earlier we were chasing those things, but they will automatically come to us as a shadow, and therefore we are gainer both ways, that we are having our permanent inheritance, as also we are not missing anything, rather we are getting premium products, premium comforts, and all these things required for a happy living. So that is our good fortune. Now Baba says, everything has got numbers. Like Baba has given us the example of the rosaries, that although we are all fortunate, but then there are more fortunate, and then they are most fortunate, that we all know. And there lies our role. So slowly and slowly, the boatman carried our boat across, and now slowly and slowly the time of this completion of the old drama and the beginning of new drama is just about to come. it is more close than we any of us thinks. So therefore now, on the way, Baba has also been slowly changing the ways and means, depending upon that Baba started in the beginning and then, you know, elementary knowledge was given, elementary efforts were taught, and then slowly, you know, just as in education, one studies, advanced studies, that things become more subtle, more powerful. So here also, earlier times, you know, Baba used to tell us, children, you know, you have to be careful about your action, your speech. But if any storm comes in the mind, it is natural. So that was pardoned. That was not, you have not to consider that. Just take care of your speech and actions. Now the things have changed. The knowledge has become advanced. And all tools of our reaching our goal have become very subtle, but very powerful. We all know this, and we have been experiencing this and living this. Now, where we are, what is the, where the needles are in the world clock, we know that it can be any time for two reasons. One is the evident reason that we are finding the conditions of the world. The second is the knowledge that Baba has given us, that for any Brahman, confluence can be over any time. Yesterday also, one brother was asking me, Brijmohan Bhai, what do you think, but how much time is left? So I smiled and did not reply. I told him that, brother, even if I make my personal guess, it will not be in the interest of myself and yourself or anybody else to tell you the time that I am thinking is left, because for us it is so clear that today I leave my body and my confluence period is over. So that is the always we should keep in mind, never make a guess that maybe that some time is left. This thought Mama kept in her mind in practical life, and her slogan was also like that. And as a consequence, as a result, she was the first, you know, if you see the history of the Yajna, the first and the earliest one who attained perfection. Similarly, all others, you know, Baba used to say, tell, next new year will not come. And those who really took it to their heart that next new year will not come, they made speedy efforts, fast efforts, and the history of the Yajna tells you that they attained their perfection state. But there are others who feel that so many new years have come, and Baba said 60 years ago, next new year will not come, perhaps this time also, next new year may come. So that is the catch. So therefore, on it depends how much time we have to attain perfection, in how much time we have to complete our responsibilities here, in how much time we have to finish our old karmic account, change sanskar, depends on our this consciousness. And now it is easier to establish our mind on that focus, because visibly the end of the physical drama is near. Nobody can deny that. Earlier there used to be doubt. You know, when Baba Yajna was established, not even the first atom bomb, the tiny baby bomb, was invented. At that time, Baba used to say the world will finish and there will be huge fires. Nobody could comprehend. But slowly, slowly, all those things that Baba told slowly and slowly they are revealing themselves and becoming real. Similarly, Baba says, now for no Brahman, it is difficult to understand that the end is just facing us. End means that our time of completion, the time up to which Shiv Baba, God Almighty, came on earth in this dirty world just for our sake. So now also Shiv Baba, Brahma Baba are in the subtle region still. They are not in the corporeal world now, they don't come, but subtle region still to help us in the last, you know, a lot. And Baba used to say, the board of late has been placed, but too late board has not been placed, because once the too late is board is stuck, then nobody can do anything. We can only think, enjoy or repent. That is the situation. So for that means now we have to pack up. Now we have to withdraw. Now we have to, whatever we had spread, that we have to now concentrate. The question is, concentrate up to what extent? That is the basic question. You know, we had spread, and we know how much we spread. The soul has the sanskars of 84 births, that is almost the whole cycle. Now that we know how much spread is there, we can imagine that if now I want to concentrate my mind completely, that I am a point, which really I am, which I have to become. Is it possible? Even when Baba gives us exercise of taking the mind to different regions, for Paramdham, Baba always tells the shortest time. Baba says, be for just half a minute, for a second, because that is, by intellect we can be there, but practically taking our mind, intellect, sanskar totally to that state becomes difficult, because our spread has not been totally concentrated. So basically, now we have to just ponder and decide in what form finally I am going to be there when this particular drama ends. So we know that all of us started from Paramdham. And in Paramdham, what we were? Points, sentient points of light and might. Okay. Now we have to become that, which means everything, all the things, all the spread we have to withdraw, complete everything in all respects, and become point again, and a pure point, because here the point, you know, otherwise also people say a point has no length, breadth, height, weight. Point is a point. That is the physical point they think of. But we are, you know, chetana, sentient points. So to get back into that state means to withdraw. And withdraw mentally. Not that, say, Malaysia is thinking of having a solar system, and we say, no, we have to become point, so we won't do that. No, that is not the intention. The idea is we have to now shift our status. We had established in this corporeal world thoroughly and completely since long. Now we are established here, but now we have to change our destination of establishment and we have to stay here. We have to just stay. And for this, Baba has given us the example of a guest house. It was my house, and now I have sold it. But the new buyer has allowed me to stay here in my house till he comes and takes over. So that is the situation. Earlier, we were very much here, belonged here. Whatever our life was spent here. But now we have to shift. Many times, you know, when a government falls of a particular party, and then the president allows that prime minister to continue in office as a caretaker till the new president is elected and takes office. So that caretaker, now it is also directed to him that you have not to make any major decisions. You are just a caretaker. So similarly, we have to change our status. Baba sometimes says of a guest or of a trustee. So of all, we have been trained for long, right from our date of birth as a Brahmin, to be trustees. Isn't it? We say Baba's center, Malaysia retreat center belongs to whom? We say to Baba. And we also belong to Baba. What Baba says, to be a BK means to surrender to Baba, because that gives us a lot of advantages and power, gives us rights to become Baba's children and get Baba's all help, support and inheritance. So therefore, we have been trained to be trustees. Okay. Now Baba says, the trust that I had established is also going to be wound up, because that was also established for a particular purpose. So taking that into consideration, we have to be more actively all the time to be a trustee, which means that we belong now there and we have come here. That is what Baba says, to have constant yoga. What is the method? If we try to think that we are here in this world, in this body, and our soul has to go up and reach Paramdham or think of the golden age, it becomes difficult because the pull of gravity, my body is on this earth by the pull of gravity, and gravity is connected to graveyard, isn't it? So long as this costume, which has to be consigned to graveyard, we are imprisoned in that, we are caged in that, and think of going up. You may throw anything with best of your power, it will come down because it is the pull of gravity. So therefore, now we have to dissociate. Earlier, we had to be in the consciousness of the soul, function as a soul through the body. But now, almost it is a time to fly up. So therefore, what I am trying to do myself is that be there and come here. So from soul world, we know that we cannot now go back to soul world directly. So therefore, presently we cannot come back also from the soul world directly. The subtle region where our Brahma Baba is, Shiva Baba is, and from where all the now teachings, all the signals, everything is coming. So that is our, I will say, the biggest retreat center of the Brahmins. we have retreat center on this globe, but for all the Brahmins, because it is open all the time, Baba used to say that children, when I come here, there is limitation of time, limitation of the body in which I come, but there it is all 24/7. There is no day there, no night there, there is no body there, so nothing. That is why Brahma Baba, long back on 18th January 69, took that form. You know, Baba has linked many things together. So Brahma Baba took that form for two reasons. We know that the children had also to take those responsibilities turn by turn, because in the golden age also, the kingdom has to go turn by turn. More than that, Brahma Baba felt, although he had fully surrendered, like we are also fully surrendered, but still there were limitations of physical limitations of the body. You have to give it rest, sleep, food, so many things. If you it has to travel, then you have to carry the body. Yes, sir, now if I had to travel to Malaysia, it will take so many things. But by this online, we are meeting just like, and we are enjoying the same as we would have been by physically traveling. There also, I could not come to all your centers, all your rooms or places. Now we are able to do. So Baba said, because my all the tools are spiritual and subtle, Baba did it long ago, so became subtle. By becoming subtle, the speed of service or of reaching of the thoughts increases, you know, like anything, because thought moves the fastest, and we all have the mind. The only thing is whether mind is controlling me, or I am controlling mind, or I am controlling my mind in many respects, but still there are certain respects in which mind is controlling me. So all those we know intricacies. So therefore, now we have to shift our headquarters. Just as I, Brij Mohan, have shifted my headquarters from Delhi to Mount Abu. Similarly, we have all to shift our headquarters to subtle region. From there to function, just as I go from my home to my job. But I return to my home is the main place for me. That is only my duty. Similarly, we start in the morning as subtle angels, because Bab Dada is subtle. We meet Bab Dada, take blessings from Bab Dada, Amrit Vela powers we get from Bab Dada. Baba automatically fills us. Just as children, the parents in the morning, they bathe them, prepare them, give them new dress and all that, new hanky and so on. Similarly, Bab Dada, we come to the Amrit Vela and Bab Dada fills us completely. This is a normal thing. In the world also we do, every in morning with you, all the supplies are in position. And then, as subtle angels, because I can transfer to another soul whatever I have. So when I am in body conscious stage and teaching another soul consciousness, unless I become soul conscious to that extent, my body consciousness will also transfer to that person. That is why the other person says, this teacher is better than the other. Because the voice may be sweet, the way of rending may be done, or the body may be attractive and so on. Although the same knowledge is being passed on. Similarly, Baba says, now the advantage will be, we are in subtle state, So in settled state, we have already packed up and concentrated so many of our things which we had expended. So any other soul also will do that. So it comes to what Baba says, Mansa Seva, service through the mind. Because all technologies have been improving from basic and primary. Similarly, our this spiritual technology is now has become very subtle but very powerful. So for that, how many people we could reach by word of mouth? How many souls we could reach even by television and other modern means of communication? Baba says, you have to reach last soul also of the world. Because we are at the roots. We are connected directly to Shri Baba. We are Baba's direct children. So our responsibility also, we know that we have to liberate ourselves. We have liberated, but all souls of the world who may not know our language, who may not even be knowing what is happening, just as the leaves of the tree, the top twig of the tree, they are also to get sustenance from the roots. So that is our responsibility. Baba says, you are the pillars, you are the foundation, you are the roots. But the roots are above now. That is why it is shown as an inverted tree. So we have to now think only of seva. Whatever little thing, our incompletions are there, those will also be automatically completed when we serve others. That is why in every sentence, in every lesson, Baba says, do it for yourself, then give to others. Be always happy and then give happiness to others. Get this knowledge, give this knowledge to others. Because the roots are not meant for themselves. Those roots remain green and always live, even when the tree is drying up, because they are connected with the seed and their job is only to throw up all the sustenance. In the process, they remain green and live. So therefore, if we think that I have to be in the subtle region, I have to withdraw from all superfluous. And Baba says, all waste, because waste is weight. And the little tiny sentient soul, if you get a little weight also of waste thoughts, or now ordinary thoughts also, Baba says, because now by road transport, you cannot reach your destination. You have to be in the rocket. So therefore, that also is clear to us. So I become subtle and perform my jobs here also, just as a diver in the ocean goes deep down to pick up pearls or whatever, but is connected up so that anything happens, it can be lifted. Similarly, Baba says, one thing is to remain in subtle state. The other important and most important is to remain connected. Because earlier there was option. You get connected, sometimes you get disconnected. But Baba says that our strength and ability to serve the entire world through the subtle process is by remaining connected. Because with our own power, individual power, we cannot serve the whole world. So when Baba says, do service through the mind, we have to be connected with Baba, and Baba will give us enough power if we do not have to serve each and every soul. Because this service is also means you have to be liberated, grossly liberated, then liberated from other things, so much so that liberated from our body and even from whatever little is left of our karmic accounts, which can also pull us, which means we have to be totally focused. Not even thinking of any worldly news, anything superfluous, because like scientists, we have to be totally focused. And with the power of Baba and understanding what we are doing, Baba says, how you will reach through mind other souls. So Baba says it is like the rays of the sun or rays coming out of a diamond. So those rays are all of all colors, which means to say that all type of powers and all type of gunas or qualities we will be emitting. And automatically, whosoever in this world, whichever soul wants what, they will get that. Baba has told us that today's souls are miserably caught in the web of desires, unending desires, because they have no aim and object, they know nothing about the drama, they know nothing about the spiritual journey. So those desires, insatiable desires, and they feel miserable because they fulfill one desire, then 10 more arise, and it is becoming more and more difficult to fulfill your desires. Baba's children, Baba says that the children know we have attained whatever we had to attain. In one word, Baba says happiness, which is our birthright. Baba says you emit happiness, your face will show happiness, your eyes will show happiness. So we have ended our desires, so we can, our one ray reaching anyone with desires will also liberate the soul from those desires. So Baba has created a sufficient number of souls in the form of Brahmins who are to do that. Then there is fear, lot of fear, and Baba's children have no fear because we already know what is going to happen and we are already preparing ourselves for that. Then real love, people are starved of real love. Everyone is betraying them. In the name of love, they are exploited. So even the multimillionaires or whosoever you may call, they need real spiritual selfless love, which Baba gives us in plenty. And we have also the capacity to pass on, because whenever we serve any soul, we are selfless. We do not have any motive. Yes, Almighty God came by taking mercy on them, by being generous, large-hearted. So we also have those capacities. So spiritual love, spiritual power, and spiritual energy to be able to finish our desires, then also they want peace. Most thing wanted them is peace, because Baba says, even if I am peaceful, if the atmosphere around me is not peaceful, then I can't be really peaceful also. The very atmosphere can disturb my deep peace. That is why Baba has said that if in the end, when all the elements are, out of control and so many upheavals are happening, if you try to do yoga at that time or try to concentrate, you won't be able to do that. Therefore, we have to become that powerful that we influence and we are not influenced by anything. Whatever it may be, even good things, even Baba says your service, good service, your good qualities can also become a chain or a bondage. If we don't remember that we have to be karmatit, we may perform, but we should not get influenced by either my performance or anybody else's performance, even good. So we have to be above that, which means only an angel can do that. An angel can think of the whole world, and a human being in body may start thinking of the limited, unless the conscience is kept universal. So even you know a limited thing limits your everything, all your capacities and all your attainments. Therefore, now is the time to, we have a lot of knowledge, we have a lot of understanding, we have a lot of things kept in our lockers, in our treasures. Baba says, use them. Many of us know we have certain capacities, but we thought we will use them, let the opportunity come. Now Baba says, use them, otherwise they will become useless. So this is the situation, my dear sisters and brothers. So we have, we know collectively what we have to do. Baba says, if all my Brahmins collectively can avoid waste, can avoid questioning, can be in the stage that whatever is happening is correct, accurate, whatever will happen will be for the better, whatever any Brahman is also doing is right, and I have good wishes for everyone. If all of us can be in a stage of good wishes and good thinking, Baba says, our work will be completed on time. Om Shanti.
Thank you, Brij Mohan Bhai, for such a powerful sharing. Very powerful words. You know, we are being forewarned to be forearmed. And also the end is facing us. Now we don't waste our thoughts. We don't waste our words. We don't waste our deeds. We have to make sure that they are all put into elevated use to bring about elevated treasures and to be shared with the whole world. Yeah. So I think you have given us a lot of food for thoughts to prepare ourselves. So once again, thank you for sharing with us. So we do have some time. Would you like to take any question, brother?
That's what I thought, that if there are any questions, we can take up.
So any questions from the floor?
Maybe I can ask a question.
Yes, okay.
Brij Mohan Ji, you covered a lot about the benefits of online learning and online classes. And I think, although initially we thought that it might be a little negative effect on the Brahmins, but overall it looks like the Brahmins have adapted very well with online studies and classes and so on. The thing is that, when do you think that Madhuban will open? Mm-hmm. So that we can come back to Madhuban.
You know, time always moves. Time. You know, are you able to hear me?
Yeah. Yes, brother.
Time always moves forward. Okay. There will be tomorrow, but not yesterday.
Okay.
So the whole world is making the mistake only is that they want to pull time backwards. They want this Kaljuga to become Satyuga. Baba says it is not possible unless the Kaljuga is destroyed. No old person can become young. He can become a baby, provided he looks forward, leaves this body and takes that baby body. So by that, by token of that, you can understand that there will be refinement, more refinement, and still more refinement. Ultimately, I and you have to become a point. So for that reason, Baba is preparing us. Many of the Brahmins feel a lot of convenience and comfort in this online business. But it does not mean we should be complacent. There some of them start thinking, not taking it seriously. They come online, then they start taking their food also, listening. And no, you have to take it in the right sense that this is a physical method of ultimately making us subtle. When we used to say, please avoid bad company, don't eat with people who are not having good sanskara, people used to question. But now, as per drama, you know, social distancing has become, so Baba is teaching him the hard way. So we people, Brahma Baba became online in 1969, just imagine. So therefore, it is a very good thing for us, and we have not to reach only Madhuban. Now we have to think of reaching, you know, Paramdham via subtle region. So our Madhuban is, Baba says, Madhuban is everywhere, where you make it. Of course, we used to come to Madhuban because there were vibrations, there was the atmosphere built by years of tapasya and those things there. But now Baba says the time is not there left, because just think, it was Baba's plan that Baba made a schedule for all the children to come to Madhuban, you know, one party coming, one going. Now, like you and me, all Brahmins want to come to Madhuban. If they actually come, will the Madhuban be able to accommodate them? And if some of them do not come and others come, will it be fair? So therefore, Baba says, even our service is the last stage will be that we will be attaining angelic stage, and then we will become visible as angels. You will find people in Malaysia will start thinking that they are finding some angels, just like Baba says, like flying saucers they used to see. Who are they? And then, you know, that is our final state. So we have now to take other souls to Paramdham. So for that reason, personally, I think that new methods will be found. You may be going in trance and being in Madhuban, things like that. But physical, this is my own personal, because I do not know the drama. Personally, I feel things will become subtler and subtler, and there will be no going back like that. Earlier in Madhuban, there were dadis. There were no, Baba has lifted them also one by one. And it is a telling to us, you also lift yourself. If you want to meet the dadis, appointment in subtle region. Okay.
Om Shanti.
Ji.
Mohanbhai, my question is just for the benefit of everyone. What's your current effort? You know, you know very clearly how things are going to happen. What specific effort you are making at this point of time?
Brother, my current effort is to concentrate, so that I can pack up everything in my point.
Right. Very, very sharp. Always be in a concentrated form, yeah? Second question is, I was thinking, you know, we want to expand service. Sometimes we are thinking that social media is there, and why not we go all out to use the ability in social media and publicize our program. That's one. The other area is we normally do a lot of yoga for a public program. So now within these two, in the context of time, how do we go about? Do we use both, or will we want to do a lot of service?
Yes.
Whether we can use the social media or the traditional method of yoga power, because we are also become much more powerful now, more subtler now. So between these two, what's our choice? Social media also means that the energy is also going into something physical.
Brother, I personally believe Brahma Kumaris are unique. Okay?
Yeah.
And unique means like no one else. So when the time is to concentrate, you know, if you mix up into social media, there are so many options there. And a person will, you know, just as these days people want to see something on mobile, then they then superfluous things also. Social media is not the method for us. We are already very well known. Our services are well known. We are powerful. So there is no need now to make ourselves known through social media or our program. Baba says all souls who have to come in Brahmin clan as per drama, they will come. Even if you don't publicize at all. There was a time, you know, to make something valuable and to the people, you have to publicize. Now there is no need. So we will just Brahma Baba in the beginning used to do. Brahma Baba used to invoke sitting in yoga. And Baba says, each Brahmin, if he concentrates a thought and then wants to send it anywhere, it will reach. Brahma Baba practically did it. We know the history that all the double foreigners were invoked by Brahma Baba in corporeal form. And just after Brahma Baba left the body, after 2-3 years, foreign service started. Even when the yajna was in the economically poor, became poor state, Brahma Baba invoked. And you know, at the right time, the right type of things came. So now we are so many. We should only invoke the souls, either reach them, or Baba says, when your angelic forms will appear all over the world, some people will have visions, then they will automatically be attracted. Otherwise, also like a flame attracts the moths. So we have to become like that, you know. So this social media is not a very sort of, to me, very important thing for us to go into.
Thank you.
Goodbye. Ah, yes.
Many times in the early days, okay, that the Rocket government is going to hand power over to the Pandava government. So how would that happen? You think you can foresee at the very end? How does the Rocket government hand over power to the godly government, the Pandava government? And the second question is glorification. I know glorification from Madhuban, India is possible, happening. But in our own places, how does glorification of Baba really happen actually? In what way glorification will happen? These two questions. How the Rocket government hand over the power to the godly government. Secondly, is the question is, how do we glorify Baba in our own way? In our own place?
Yes. Brother, there are certain things which Baba has to do and there are certain things which we have to do. The first question, Baba will do as per drama, and we need not apply our mind or thoughts to this question. It had happened every kalpa and it will happen. How? Wait and see. The second one, you know, Baba says glorification will not now come through any argument or any superiority of our jnana. It will come through our practical lives. That is why Baba is saying that whatever you are having in store, you have kept in your mind, make it practical. Myself also had so much in store that because Baba has given me the job of glorifying Bhagavad Gita. So I used to think that I held so many programs, made a team of BKs and all that. Still, it was not being glorified. So I thought, how it will be glorified? So Baba says it will not be glorified by such like thing, by our own. Now anybody sees any Brahma Kumaris anywhere, you know, either going by plane or anywhere, every person is very curious because of the white dress. Baba says, but also because of the appearance and everything, that these people look different. So Baba says, more we become spiritual, more we become angelic, so it is not necessary for people to see angels in the sky. They will see you, and in situations, supposing some accident takes place, something frightening happens, they will see the BKs are unaffected. So they will definitely be attracted, after all, who they are. And this is how we will be glorified everywhere, not only in Mount Abu. Mount Abu, I am personally feeling, maybe that some souls, some people will get visions. This is my own thinking, of angels around Mount Abu, and that will spread. And that is why people will queue up, that see where it is coming from. But not only Mount Abu, each and every center of Baba is a place of pilgrimage for the local people. So therefore, we have to just work on ourselves now. So much so, we should ourselves start feeling that we are becoming angels, we are angels. The more you live in angelic state and you walk through the streets or do your work, that is the best social media. They see you and they will feel there is something in them, and they will ask you. This is how Baba is going to be manifested very soon. That is why Baba says, now concentrate your spread and bring it into your face. Your eyes should be spiritually smiling. Your lips should be spiritually smiling. Your soul should be reflecting spirituality. So we will be becoming like the mobile messengers of God.
We have reached the time, but I think we have asked one last question to brother. This question is, Baba says that whatever happens in the beginning will happen at the end. Can you share what are the things that is happening in the beginning we are seeing now at the end?
Yes. You know, in the beginning, it was only spiritual power with which the yajna grew. You know, in the end also, all worldly activities will automatically come to a stop. We may have cars, but will not be able to move cars, either the petrol, whatever situation. So in that situation, we will become like, you know, people say, ordinary people of the early times, who had no means and no facilities. Even your internet, this, that will go. So at that time, spiritual power will work. Baba has said in so many murlis, wireless will also fail, but voiceless will work. So that is the idea. That earlier time, Brahma, Baba and a few children, with which power the whole world was opposing. Nobody knew this. People will laugh that God has come. But spiritual power, they never compromised with the principles, and they were otherwise very polite and courteous. So slowly, spiritual power showed itself. Just as a seed in the soil, suddenly the soil breaks and a small plant comes. So same thing will happen. Baba means to say that all the means and other tools which are available to us will not be available. And only our voicelessness, our purity, our spirituality, you will be able to even communicate. Baba will even guide you that earthquake is coming, you should be standing there or you should move. So that will be the thing.
Thank you, Brij Mohan Bhai Ji, for such a powerful sharing. I like the point that you said about, you know, we have not the biggest retreat center is actually the southern region, and we should move ourselves there now, pack ourselves and go up there first. Yeah.
There we can meet often. Huh?
Yes. Okay. My office can be next to your office.
Yes.
So yes. Om Shanti, once again, thank you very much to Brother Brij Mohan Bhai Ji.
Om Shanti.
We will have a few minutes of Drishti from you.
Okay.
Thank you.